Over the last few weeks and months, we've been wrestling with the idea of three things that Clifton children are very familiar with. And we call it campfires, watering holes and caves. And campfires merely refer to the where staff are engaging with large groups of children at the same time. And then watering holes is where they're given an opportunity to go and break up in smaller groups, wrestling with either problems or ideas. And then the third component, which is the cave, where the child has an opportunity to sit and just work through content or wrestling with problems by himself. Now, how do we actually implement this in a similar way at home? You see, as parents, we are constantly thinking about ways on how we engage with our children. Firstly, the campfires, where we as families are sitting together and just love spending time together. And then the smaller, intimate group environments that we refer to as the watering holes, where it's just you and your child. But you either take him or her for a round of golf or play a bit of tennis or just perhaps have a milkshake. And then that third option, which is in isolation, the cave, where we allow them just to be on their own, even experiencing a bit of boredom in what is referred to at Clifton as the cave. I hope that you find these three principles useful in the way that we're intentionally looking for ways to engage with our children. Have a fantastic week, and I hope you rest well during what I believe is a well-deserved half term. All the best.
Is a bloom shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you'd found a friend take you out of this place, someone you can lend a hand in return.